Hi, it's me again with CorelDRAW Tips and Tricks. And another, somebody else asked me how to resize my penny box, make a drop a penny game. And you could, you know, resize it to, he wants to resize it to like, he's got a lot of scrap wood and it's 3/16 inch plywood. There's a way inside of CorelDRAW to do that, but it would take you a long time. And I just made a video a couple weeks ago about how to extend. The box itself will be the same. It just needs, these tabs need to be a little bit longer, 1/16 of an inch longer, because this is 1/8 and he wants it 3/16, which, so it's just 1/16 of an inch longer. Inside of the free software, it'd be easier to just make a box 6x2x3 and your thickness is 0.185, which is 3/16 quarter inch tabs. And if you don't know how to continue that video or continue that process, search a couple of videos and there, it's out there. But you've got my, so you've got the size, and I smart filled them. So this is going to be the top. So you've got my file. These are your sides and your two sides and your top. Top and bottom are the same. You could put it in the center of the page, take my file. Let me do this the right way. Grab all that, move it down here, take away my box, Control G to group it together, and hit P. Now you have my design with the penny and the right size holes for your box. Now, the only thing the free software doesn't do is to create tabs, but I made a video the other day on how to make these, and you don't really have to have this. You know, you could make, you know, test it out with a penny. I did this so the penny will drop straight down and be loose. This is 0.75 inches. And then this little shelf keeps them from going in. You can make this, you know, you could take a penny and make it not fall through there. And then you wouldn't need a shelf. But then you could, and to make an easy one, you could just cut a, you know, a hole in the bottom. You wouldn't have to use my door, even though I really like my new door. And I just made a video today on how to lock it and how to glue it together. But you could put my door inside of this end. So let's just do that. Let's hit P. Let's take this one, move it out here. Let's ungroup it. Well, it's evidently not grouped. So let's just grab that. Break curve apart. Grab just the box and hit P. And now you've got my door opening inside of the new door, of the new end. The only thing that would be difficult would be to make these tabs, to make the shelf. You don't have to make the tabs. To make it easier, this is the piece you want in there. You could make it just the size of the box and put little supports and just glue it in there a certain height down. You know, make some legs on the side of the box, and what I'm trying to get at there, to save you a little time. Nobody's gonna be able to see it. So what I would do is, you know, make you a piece of plywood, and this is the long part, and you got your hole cut in the middle for the number 6 penny to fall through. And just take you some little blocks of wood and glue them in there for this thing to set on. And if you got it tight, you can put some glue around the top. The penny's not gonna, you know, and this is on the side, so your door is, and I would keep this away from the door so it won't interfere with the mechanism. But if you put a couple of little bitty blocks of wood or even pieces of plywood for it to set on while you're gluing it, that would be the easiest box to make. Anyway, I hope that answered his question. And thank you for watching.